Thank you, Lightstream, for sponsoring this video. So today I'm gonna show you how you can go ahead and multi-stream directly from your Xbox to platforms like Twitch, YouTube, Kick, Facebook, and any RTMP destination without the need of a capture card or having an expensive computer. All you need is a computer to be able to set this up initially, and then afterwards, you can manage everything from your phone. So the software that we're gonna utilize is gonna be Lightstream Studio. Now, if you're already using Lightstream Studio, this feature of multi-streaming is already included in your plan at no additional cost. So if you don't have Lightstream Studio, it's gonna be $8 a month or $60 a month for 720p or 1080p, or you can go annually and pay 7 and 14. Now, I do not recommend going for the 60 FPS because Xbox can only support 30 FPS. So the 720p or the 1080p plan is the one you want to select. And then you'll get a 7-day free trial to be able to go ahead and try everything. And if you use the link in the description below, you'll get 25% off your first month. So once you go ahead and create your account, you're going to be brought to a dashboard just like this. Now, this is going to be the software they're going to utilize to not only have overlays on your console stream, but also to be able to multi-stream to multiple destinations at the same time. Okay, so the first thing you're going to want to do here is you're going to come to the left and you're going to go ahead and name your project. And then you're going to go ahead and select the resolution based on the plan that you went ahead and selected. Super important that you toggle auto live project on. What this means is that when you go live on your Xbox to Twitch, it's going to automatically go live with your overlays and the destination that you went ahead and selected. So make sure you have that there. I'm going to go ahead and utilize a project that I went ahead and created that already has my overlays set up here. And towards the end of this video, I'll show you how to go ahead and get overlays set up just like I have here with my starting soon, my countdown, and my different scenes. So now, on the top right-hand side, you're going to see the option to select a destination. Now, by default, Twitch is selected. It is mandatory for Twitch to be one of the platforms for you to be able to stream from because that's the only console destination that you have available on the Xbox. So it has to go from Twitch directly to Livestream, and that's how Livestream sends it over to the other platforms. So once you have Twitch selected, you're going to come here and add additional destinations. Now, you can stream up to 5 destinations, with one of them being Twitch, and then the other 4 can be other Twitch accounts, other YouTube accounts, a Facebook account, a Kick account, or any other destination using RTMP like Trovo and stuff like that. So let's go ahead and add our first destination. I'm going to make sure it's YouTube. So once you select the YouTube icon, it's going to ask you to go ahead and get logged in. So once you go ahead and get logged in, it's going to say allow. And if you've never live streamed before on your YouTube account, you have to go to your YouTube account and authorize live streaming. And then it takes 24 hours for you to be able to get access. So just keep that in mind. Once you have that there, you can toggle it on. And now here's where you have the option to go ahead and put in your stream title. So I'm going to just put this is a test. And then the description, this is a test. And then here, very important for privacy, you have 3 options. Public means that anyone can be able to see your live stream. Private means that only you can see your live stream. And then unlisted means that only you can see your live stream, or people who have the link to your live stream can be able to view it. So I'm going to go ahead and leave it as unlisted. And then we're going to go ahead and add Kick as the other destination. So to do that, you're going to click RTMP. You're going to name this Kick. You're going to toggle on. It's going to ask you for the URL and the stream key. So once you log into your Twitch account, you're gonna come to the left-hand side and select stream key. You're gonna select this URL, you're gonna come back and you're gonna paste the URL directly in there. Then you're gonna go back, select the stream key, and then you'll paste that there as well. And now we have that selected. So right now we're telling Livestream, every time that we go live on our Xbox to Twitch, please send over our stream over to YouTube and Kick. And remember, you still have the option to add 2 more destinations, whether that be Facebook or another RTMP destination. So once we got ahead and set this up here, okay, we now wanna make sure we have everything set up on our Xbox to make sure we're able to send our stream directly to Livestream. So on your Xbox, you're gonna hit the home button on your controller. You're gonna come over to the section that says capture and share. You're gonna come down and select live streaming. And if you've never live streamed before from your Xbox, you'll get prompted here to connect your Twitch account. And once you do, you'll be brought to a dashboard just like this. So the first thing is you wanna go ahead and select your stream title for your Twitch stream. Then you're gonna wanna make sure you have your microphone turned on. If this is off, that means you don't have a microphone connected to your controller or to your Xbox. So I'm gonna select on. And then if you have a camera connected to your Xbox, this is where you would want to turn that on, and that will be sent over to Livestream as well. So now for more options, this is super important. For party audio, if you want the stream to pick up the people who are in your party, you need to turn this on. And then your people in your party have an option above their name that says include audio and broadcast. That must be selected as well for them to be able to be heard. Then you have the option to adjust your game volume, your microphone volume. But here's the important information we need for live stream resolution. You want to select the same one that you selected inside of Lightstream. So I'm going to select that there. And then for the destination, you want to go ahead and make sure that this is not on Twitch by default. You want to make sure that it's on Lightstream. Once you've gone ahead and done this, you can now go ahead and press go live on the Xbox. And when you do that, it's going to go ahead and pop up everything here inside of Lightstream Studio. And then you'll be able to go live and go to those different destinations. Now, just having your stream go to Lightstream and going to all these different platforms is a great opportunity to be able to grow your stream. But if you want your stream to look professional with overlays like I have them set up here, well, go ahead and watch this video right here where I walk you step by step on how to set up overlays inside of Lightstream Studio when you stream directly from your Xbox. Click that video right there. I'll see you guys in the next video.